everyone, in this month and upcoming months, this channel will cover tutorials on Kdenlive. So if you doesn't know how to use it, do watch my tutorials. In this video, I'm going to cover some of its features. But before that, I'm going to cover two important questions. Number one is, how much one have to pay to use it? And the answer is, nothing. It's an open source software, that means you don't need to pay anything to anyone to download, install and use it. Number second is, on which operating system one can use it? And the answer is, it's cross-platform. That means you can use it on Windows, Mac and Linux. After knowing this, let's see some of its features. Number one is multi-track audio and video editing. As you can see, you can add multiple audio or video tracks. That means it is very easy to create overlay videos with it. It will be very easy to create those videos where you want to add background music and narration. Number second is use any audio or video format. You don't need to convert your audio or video to import it into Kdenlive. It almost supports all the major audio and video formats, so it will save you a whole lot of conversion time. Number three is customizable interface. You can change the interface as per the need of your project. All these windows are dockable, that means you can move them anywhere you want. Number four is titler. Do you like the status which appear before or middle part of the video? With Kdenlive, you can create your own custom titles. And not only that, you can save them as template and you can use them in future projects. Number 5 is mini effects and transitions. Dozens of effects are available, ranging from color correction to audio adjustments, as well as all the standard transform options. Number 6, automatic backup. Your project file is automatically backed up every few minutes later. That means if anything bad happens, you won't lose your work. The next time you will start the Kdenlive, you will get the backup copy of your project. So these are some of the features of Kdenlive. There are more which we are going to see in upcoming tutorials. In the next tutorial, we are going to see how to download and install Kdenlive. Thanks for watching. See ya.